Ungdomsrat.
Hello everyone, you are listening to You've Got 5 Options show on
Ungdomsradio.
Tune in at 98.7 every Monday and Wednesday at 11:30 and every odd Friday at 2 o'clock.
Join us while we are solving yet another life challenge, and if you decide to share your problem with us, yours can be next.
Hello everyone, this is Marta
and this is Anna
and this is You've Got 5 Options show.
Yes, and we are welcoming you on this beautiful Monday and I think it's still cold, isn't it?
I think it's very cold.
Yeah, I'm actually traumatized. Like the last 3 days, I spent waiting for buses or trains in a pure cold. I really felt like I'm in Game of Thrones or something. I felt like I'm on the wall. It was terrible. It's like, Denmark, I don't know what you are doing, but please stop.
Yeah, they should have some better, border control, right?
Exactly.
Lame joke.
Exactly, you should think about it. What do you think, Lasse? Lasse is here, by the way.
Yeah, hi. Have a nice Monday. Good morning. well, it's a late morning on Monday. but it's too cold. It should be illegal, I think.
It should be, right?
Yeah.
Exactly. We should be able to, sue someone for that. It's terrible.
Yeah.
Now, guys, really, I am still frozen. I really got frozen last week. And I still didn't totally got warm again. This is how bad it was. And I think a part of my brain might be also not functioning properly. So if you will hear something weird today, that's my brain not working. Okay, maybe that wasn't a necessary point to point out.
I think
Marta,
that
help me point to point out.
I think that we are here in a really awesome state. I have not really slept that this weeks that much.
I think you meant years.
Okay, yeah, 6 years plus, but recent few weeks it has been pretty tough, so my brain is also kind of in a weird state, and then Lasse told us that he overslept and is kind of, so we are a dream team today.
My god, we will solve any life challenge that will come our way, because together we have one functioning brain, if we will add it, the part that is working with me and yours and Lasse, I think we have one brain and we can do magic with it. We just have to coordinate it.
Yes, so don't worry, Tobias, we've got you covered.
Yeah, that's the name of the guy. Of course, that's the name of the guy that we invented, but I like this, Tobias. It's is it biblical?
I don't know, maybe we can ask Google.
Google time.
But I would also like to make a little announcement. We have opened last week a YouTube channel where you can listen to all of our radio shows, including our live shows, which are apparently quite embarrassing and hilarious. So if you would like to, if you ever skipped any of the radio shows, you can go on YouTube and put in a search, You've Got 5 Options, and then you will find it and you can subscribe it for free.
So you better do it.
Yeah, you better do it. And then you can also, relive this beautiful moment when you are sitting right now and listening to our show. You can relive it and, because it's there and it's for free.
And you cannot really see us there yet, but one day you will also be... Well, actually, you can see one of our movies, right?
You can see our movies. Yes, we made a movie. Lasse, do you know that we made a movie?
No, I didn't.
You
tell
didn't.
Me more.
Well, the movie was called... what was the title?
Well, I don't remember the title, but do you like Star Wars?
Oh, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
You have to see the movie. No, I know how it was called. It was Saving Christmas with You've Got 5 Options and Kylo Ren. Yes, because in a Christmas time, we have received a lot of Christmas-related challenges, because apparently, against all odds, this is the most depressing and terrible period of the year, and people are, like, you know, having a lot of problems. So we have received, I think, 5 or 6 challenges in a Christmas time, and then we just thought, okay, maybe it's a good idea just to make a short movie with 5 tips how to have a great Christmas. But it was also December, and The Last Jedi was coming out, and I haven't seen it, so I was just exploding inside, because, you know, I had a plan to see it on Christmas. And let's just say that Marta was wise and very thoughtful and mindful about the advices, and I was just disturbing her in my Kylo Ren costume and lightsaber. And by the way, apparently I've heard that I am the worst lightsaber fighter in the galaxy, because I didn't got the point that you cannot touch it. So yeah, so Lasse, you have to see it, guys, and you have to see it, and you can see it on our YouTube channel, which you can subscribe to for free.
The best commercial ever.
Yeah, I think I sold it. I really I think people will sign out of mercy.
Okay,
for a very bad marketing.
You know, yes. Now that we have a YouTube channel, that you can see a short movie there, and actually that movie has an awesome trailer. I think the trailer was
maybe even better than the movie, but that's quite typical, isn't it?
Yeah, and then you can listen to our shows.
Yes.
So that's the best channel on YouTube.
It's definitely the best Undiscovered Yet channel on YouTube, and it's
for free.
Awesome. Okay. Guys, I think I should stress it more. Lasse, why are you laughing? It's for free.
No, it's important, you know, to really, you know, for free.
Yes.
Exactly.
And, you know, because we have started a couple of days ago and we have only 5 subscribers, it means there are no commercials because we are not qualified to monetize it yet. So you will never be disturbed by the commercial. And
wow.
It's for free. No commercials. Awesome. For free. Is there anything better on YouTube?
No.
You haven't seen it yet. Okay.
So
in a break, you will go on YouTube and you will subscribe to our YouTube channel. And at least please see the trailer. Trailer is only 1 minute and 30 seconds. And there is a separate playlist where all of you guys can relive this wonderful radio show. Every episode is there.
Yes.
And thank you, Marta, for confirming my... Yes, I feel like an insane person that just needed confirmation from a best friend. Like, thank you for being there for me.
But it was a very strong yes.
Yes.
It wasn't like... Yeah.
It was yes.
Exactly.
A bit demonic.
That also happens.
Okay.
Okay, so are we ready now to help someone?
Yes, we are. Yes.
Okay, great. So we got a challenge.
Yes, we actually get that quite a lot. And not only our own, but also from you guys. And we really, really appreciate.
Yes, so we have Tobias, who has sent his challenge to us, and it's quite a challenge.
Yeah.
And I think that maybe, Anna, you should just, you know, like jump right into it and read it.
Yes, I will do that. And Marta, are you ready?
Always.
Lasse, are you ready?
Yes.
Because after our estimation, it looks like you have the biggest amount of brain working properly.
Oh, I don't know about that.
Okay. Okay. Let's listen to Tobias' challenge. So, the challenge goes like this. I would really like to start my own business. I know exactly what it will be, and I have well researched how to deal with all the practical things. I have consulted a mentor with my business plan, and it looks like a really solid and promising thing. Yet I am stuck. Even though I have my resignation form printed and signed, I keep on second-guessing myself. I have been procrastinating telling my boss. He's such a lovely gentleman who has been a great manager to me. I really don't want to disappoint him. It's very difficult to say goodbye to my good colleagues and the nice routine I've developed over the years. I feel that I'm missing the self-confidence and the trust that it will all work out. I'm also quite a shy person, and I have no idea how to overcome that, as I will have to do the networking and reach out to potential clients. Do you have any good tips for me?
Yes, Tobias, in case you have not suspected it, we do have 5 good tips for you.
5. Yes, that's actually just to sell you this secret also for free. We always come up with 5 things. That's why we are actually called You've Got 5 Options.
Yes.
Boom.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
But it's a good challenge, Marta. You are right.
It's a solid challenge. We do receive quite a big number of challenges that are related to moving on in your professional life.
Mm-hmm.
And or even starting from like figuring out what to do with your professional life and how to switch jobs and how to find out what you would like to do in the future. But it's the first one where we have a person that he knows he wants to start his own business. He knows exactly what it's gonna be. He made all the research that needed to be made. He has a confirmation from a mentor that his business plan looks solid. It's very promising and he's stuck.
Yeah, and yeah, you are right. Actually, lately we have been receiving all these challenges with people not knowing what they want. This guy actually knows what he wants and he is covered by all the facts and research. Really interesting. And the other part of the challenge, he is admitting that he also likes the comfort zone he's in and he's afraid to tell to his boss because he doesn't want to disappoint him. Which is interesting. So if he feels like it's personal, if he will say, I want to quit, then the boss will take it in a way personally. And, you know, of course, the nice routines. But also there is another bit of being quite shy. And yes, indeed, when you do have your own business, you have to get out there. You have to start to network. You have to make some kind of a PR. You have to reach out to people. So he is also seeing some sort of a obstacle there. But now the question is, how many of those things are actual obstacles and how many could be potential excuses?
Yeah, that's always a really good question. And with the manager, it seems like Tobias feels some, at least that's how I read it, he feels like some gratitude towards the mm-hmm. manager. He says that it has been a great manager to him. So probably he feels very thankful towards him. And probably he has received some very good, I don't know, either help or mentoring or something. He feels he has received something good from the manager. So he kind of doesn't want to disappoint him.
It's almost like breaking up with a person that was really good for you, but you don't feel it anymore.
And that's
right?
Exactly, yeah. That's exactly how we have prepared the answer, because it really looks, Tobias, that you are ready to move on. You've got all the facts and preparation in place. And I really think that the best thing that you can do right now is to say a couple of good goodbyes and hellos. So it's time to say goodbye to the things that have served you well, but no longer serve you, and say hello to a few things. So it's about making a transition from your past life to your new life.
That was really beautifully put, Marta, you know, the things that have served you well, but not necessarily serve you anymore. And this is actually really, really great because, you know, the fact that sometimes, I think even if I again related to a breakup, it's really easy to break up with someone or to end the relationship when things are, you know, falling apart and you are fighting. But what if you don't feel the same or you are ready to reach a new level? I think actually when I related to because it's a human relation between him and the boss, I can actually understand that can be even more challenging.
Totally, yes. And that's actually I will tell you first the five goodbyes and hellos,
mm-hmm.
and then we will go into this first one with the boss, which you, Anna, have a very good point that it feels like a breakup.
Mm-hmm.
So the first goodbye is saying goodbye to your boss. The second one is saying goodbye to your old life and routines, saying hello to your shyness. Yes, saying hello to your shyness and saying hello to your self-confidence. And the last one, saying hello to the trust.
Beautiful. You know, now I really think we should think about the music because it would fit so well. Time to say goodbye. You know the song?
Mm-hmm.
Thank God, because if I would sing it on a radio, that could be the end of me. And then you can also put hello by Lionel Richie, not Adele, because that's depressing. But you know, we should think about music. Actually, guys, if you would like to listen to some music at our radio show, just send us a message on our new website, www.thefiveoptions5as a number.com. And we actually have a form there that you can fill in and you can either tell us, except of sending us the challenge, you can also give us idea for a radio show or even be our guest or just make any comments. So if you would like to hear some music, please let us know. But I think this is, Marta, really, we never made it in this form. Of course, it's always five. But I love this idea, saying goodbye to some old things and saying hello to some new things, or actually the things that you might perceive as an obstacle, more like, you know, taming an animal, you know, okay, I'm shy. Hello to that. I love it. Okay. Good job, Marta.
Amen. Fist bump.
Hopefully Tobias also loves it.
Yeah, I also hope so, because otherwise we would just have to play music for him.
But anyway, let's start with this saying goodbye to your boss. And you already started to give that really good point, that when you feel that you have had like a really good boss, someone who has served you well as a boss for a while, and you feel some kind of attachment and also gratitude towards that person, it is quite difficult to say goodbye to it, because you are like, yeah, if I had a shitty boss, it would be like easy. I have a shitty boss, I'm just gonna quit my job. But when you have a great manager that you have been growing with, but you apparently simply can't grow any longer, or simply you have another path, you have already learned everything that you could have learned, but you have nothing to complain about regarding your boss. And it is a fact that people leave their managers much more frequently than they leave their job.
Mm-hmm, that's correct.
Many people can really like their job, but if they don't like the manager, they will be much more likely to quit it than if they don't like their job, but like the manager. It's still about leadership. We still like to have good leaders, good managers, and so on. And it's much more difficult to quit it than even if we love the job, but the manager is really crappy.
Yeah, actually, I totally agree. You know, the first job I took in corporation, I will not disclose the name of that corporation, but it was a corporation nevertheless. Danish one. Okay, I'm not saying anything more. The first time I was hired in, because I had three different positions within the same company, I chose the job because of the manager. I was overqualified for the job, and she told me, I see you are overqualified, but if you will agree, I will really develop you and stuff. And she was that was the best manager I ever had. And I took it because of her, only because of her. And I loved her, and it was a fantastic decision. And I remember actually when she resigned, because she moved first to another company, and she said the hardest part for me was to tell you guys, to tell my people that I'm leaving, because I love you all. You are all fantastic. We made a great team, and we were a great team. We were also highly performing team. But she was like, she said she was nervous. She was stressed. So actually she was like, you know, Tobias thing. But then she felt a different type of a responsibility, because she felt like we are a little bit like, well, maybe not her children, because she was kind of our age. But she said it was the worst part of all, to go and tell us that she's leaving and now we have to have a new manager or something. So this is actually against all odds. Having a great relationships at work might be even more challenging for you when you want to quit that job.
Yeah, but it really is like a breakup. I think many of us have been in this kind of relationship where we have a nice girlfriend or a boyfriend. It's fine.
And they are great humans. They have a lot of qualities, right?
Yeah. But we just don't feel it. We just know it's not the one, but it's fine. We are not fighting. We have a good communication. It's a good person, loyal, faithful, whatever kind of good qualities, but we don't feel it inside. It's very difficult to break.
Better the person is, worse it gets actually, because then you are thinking like, what the hell am I doing? You know, this is a fantastic person. I don't want to hurt him or her. So I think in case of this situation, Tobias, when you will have to say goodbye to your boss, especially to your boss, but also to your colleagues, I think, if your boss is great, of course, we don't know exactly how the boss is, but I also think that a great manager normally has a quality of a great leader and a father or a mother. So that person usually wants to see his employees grow and wants to see his employees evolve and will not cause you any problems or put you into like, why are you leaving or something like this. Although it can happen, but I think that a very honest conversation with your manager, also like reviewing all the things that you have together achieved, it's the first necessary step for you. And then, Tobias, you might discover that maybe it's not about you being afraid to disappoint your manager, but you being afraid of leaving your manager, who is a great, fantastic person.
I think it's very likely. I mean, we are always the most afraid of what is actually in our own head.
Yes.
We tend to project those things mm-hmm. to other relations, but it is usually that what really hurts us the most is what is in our heads.
Yeah, I totally agree. And I could even think, because I think that, yeah, you might be afraid that you will disappoint your manager. I think that is a part of it. But I think the feeling you are afraid the most is, you know, feeling, oh my God, feeling that you are feeling some things might be cut out, some maybe not. But remember, half of my brain or a part of it is still frozen.
Well, maybe a little.
So what I meant is, I think that even when we are in a relationship that no longer serves us with a fantastic person, we are afraid that we will leave that person to pursue other things, and then we will regret it. And actually, people around us many times are saying, what the hell are you doing? This is a fantastic person. You know, he's so good to you, he takes care of you, or she is so in love with you and she created, I don't know, home for you. What is wrong with you? You will regret it. And it can be the same, because now you are going into unknown, your own business, and you have this great manager, great leader that you can lean on. And some people would say, listen, what's your problem? You have a good job, you have a great manager, and now you're going on your own. You are throwing this to the garbage. And I think that that could also be a problem here.
And that's definitely a very tough thing to go through. But unfortunately, or I would actually say fortunately, life is about growing. Mm-hmm. If we are staying in the same place, we will never feel good. We as humans need to transform, grow, develop. It simply is the way it is. Of course, we can stay in a comfort zone for a while. That's also a good place to be for a while. It could be when we have, for example, children, small children that need a lot of support. But in a longer run, it's going to create us some, you know, issues.
Of course it will. Of course it will. You know, it's like being idle or in a limbo for years. The funny thing is, many people don't even realize it, but they do feel it. They do feel lack of motivation, inspiration, energy, or passion in their life, and they don't know what's going on, and they live through motions. And I think, Tobias, you have discovered that you want to do something else. I think you are ready. And, you know, it's not like you had an idea, you made so much research, you even have a business plan that is actually a good business plan, at least according to your mentor. You are freaking ready. We can see in your actions that you are one leg out already. That's why you will have to say goodbye to your boss. The wonderful boss you had, no matter how fantastic he is no longer a part of your journey. And this is the thing that you have to accept right now.
Exactly. So now that we have established this and we know you are ready because you have that resignation form printed and signed from yourself, how can you actually say that goodbye so that it is a good, solid goodbye that allows you to move on? There are some nice ways to say goodbye. And I think, Anna, you have read about some of them, and maybe you could comment on some of those good rituals, actually, or rituals of saying goodbye.
I knew this part will come, and now I will hope that my brain will start to unfreeze. Well, first of all, when I'm thinking about it right now, because now we are just having a discussion, right? One of the most difficult goodbyes you have to do, it's not actually with your boss, it's in your own head with your boss, because there is one aspect to it. Of course, you will have a meeting with your boss and you will tell him, and you might prepare a speech or whatever you want to say. But I don't really think that the reaction will be, you disappointed me or something. I think that the reaction will be, I'm very happy for you. Go, grow, and just move on. And I wish you all the luck and so on, right? So the goodbye you have to do is in your own head. And I think what will help you is to remind yourself why you are actually deciding to leave. Why do you want to start your own business? And then generate the gratitude for what you have already experienced with your manager. Because I am absolutely sure that your manager was a part of that inspiration. I am sure that because you had a great leader, you developed some skills or maybe a little bit of confidence. So I would maybe even write down all the things that I have learned from my manager, just to build that gratitude in me. So you will also feel better, not like a son that is, you know, running away from a father, but you will actually remind yourself that you are grateful towards him. And I think another thing I would write down are the reasons why I need to move on, why I need to leave right now, and to present it afterwards. Of course, not in a bullet point or PowerPoint presentation, but having that exercise of, I'm really grateful that I met you and you were my leader and you were my manager. And those are the reasons, because this is what I learned. But now it's time for me to move on. And the reasons for that are those. It's really, really a good idea, in my opinion. Actually, this is something I would probably also do if I would have to end a relationship with a person that is fantastic, yet I have to go.
So it is really about acknowledging that it has been an important person in your life and find that gratitude in you and basically say thank you.
Mm-hmm.
So to this person, and like really show your gratitude and say, look, I am really, really grateful that I've met you and that you were my leader, but I really have to move on. It's time for me.
I think that Marta said it very well to say thank you, but I think many times we are overusing words like thank you or I'm sorry or whatsoever. We just say thank you for everything. It was great. Bye-bye. But here you can actually make a little bit of an effort with this gratitude exercise and really write down things, you know. I remember, let's say, first week when I was here and you did this and that. Of course, it can be emotional, but it's okay. Because you are saying goodbye to a great manager and you are saying goodbye to, in some aspect, your old life. So I think it's good to point this one out and get a little bit sentimental. But it's also important for you to also write down for yourself why you want to move on. It's the same like for kids going to college, I think, as well. You know, like I love my parents, but I need to go explore. And what do you think?
Yeah, I think it's a really good tip for you, Tobias, because you really are ready. You really are ready to move on, and you're just procrastinating this because probably you still have some fears. And of course, we will touch upon the challenges that you have mentioned further on, like your self-confidence, the trust, the shyness, and so on. But it's a really good thing for you to do because you need it for your own sake. Meaning that part that Anna, you have mentioned, in your own head, you have to say goodbye in your own head. And then probably by writing down what you're grateful for and why do you have to leave, it hopefully will be easier.
We hope so too.
So guys, that will be it for this part.
Yes.
You'll get the second part of Tobias's challenge solution on Wednesday.
On Wednesday.
And it will be to say goodbye to your old life and routines, say hello to your shyness, say hello to your self-confidence, and say hello to the trust. So we are really hoping that you have benefited from this first part, a little bit of entertainment at the beginning, and then some solid good reflections and considerations on saying goodbye to important people in our lives. And we will talk to you on Wednesday.
We will. That's a promise.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
You are listening to You've Got 5 Options show. Remember that we are on air every Monday, Wednesday, and every second Friday.
Remember that you can visit our website www.youvegot5options.com. That is www.youvegot5options.com, where you can submit your challenge and find our podcast. You can also find us on iTunes or any podcast app.
Du lytter til din lokale radio i Aarhus. FM 98,7 MHz og 89,5 MHz.